World 365. I'm your host of 21st Century, and I'm here with co-founder of Uptown Magazine, Len Burnett. What's going on, Len?
What's going on, man? Nice. It's out here in Harlem, hanging out, having a great time.
Absolutely. Now, where were you when you found out you were going to be honored?
Actually, George Harrell came to the office and said, yo, we're going to honor you. I said, you know, it's great. They told me we're going to do it, and also be honoring Dougie as well. And I was, like, floored. So, yeah, I was glad to do it.
Right. How did you get hired by Vibe Magazine?
Well, actually, I was part of the team that launched Vibe back in 1993. And then left and started another company with my partner, then Keith Klinkscales. And then fast forward some 12 years later, after I launched Uptown, we had the chance to buy it back last year.
Right. Now, what made you want to co-found Uptown Magazine?
I used to have a magazine called Savoy that was a similar magazine targeted to us about lifestyle. You know, and I felt that there was a hole in the marketplace with books that dealt with us, not just from business, not from a general interest or beauty, but from a life and style. So travel, luxury, fine dining, fashion, all the things that, you know, the folks here in this room tonight are all about.
Right. Do you ever have problems trying to get clients to invest in the urban market?
In terms of advertising?
Yes.
All the time. I mean, that's been our hurdle and struggle ever since I got into the business. But it really is about an education process. The reality is, us, our African Americans as a consumer, we over-index in every aspect of the numbers and consumer purchases you can imagine. You know, the reality is that our footprint and our influence upon not only our culture, but pop culture and American culture is tremendous. And I think more and more advertisers are starting to realize that we have a long way to go, but the idea is to keep, you know, having more and more media, keep putting the word out, keep showing our influence, not only by our purchases, but also by what we don't purchase. So the idea of making sure that we hold companies accountable for our, you know, spending. And so if we keep doing that, I think over time, things will continue to get better.
Now, the urban well, not just the urban community, everyone is into digital downloading. You're in the magazine business, that's risky. How do you convince them in order to still keep your business?
Yeah, well, I think, look, the reality is that, you know, for years, the record industry, the film industry, a lot of folks, even publishing, we fought what technology had to offer. The right thing to do now, what, you know, the smart business people are doing is they're embracing it. The reality is that the consumer, you know, is going to find a way through technology to get, you know, the things that they want. You know, how can your brands, how can your products participate that in that in a way that engages them and, you know, and sort of helps to inspire them to do it as opposed to make it sort of like a blockade and having access. So that's what's really happened to the record business. If they had embraced Napster, you know, back in the late 90s, I think we'd have a different industry right now.
Right.
So now they're spinning catch-up trying to figure it out and sort of pass them by. So, you know, the idea with technology is to figure out a way to embrace it rather than fight it.
Because piracy is taking over.
Yeah, piracy is taking over. And I think, and again, technology, I think, can help to prevent that. The record industry has to get ahead of that. But again, you know, as we have to, you know, embrace technology. You know, the fact that a technology company in Microsoft and Apple, iTunes, you know, really took over the record business, and so it was on a technology basis. So again, I think as entrepreneurs, particularly African-American entrepreneurs, we have the ability to still stay ahead of that. We are, you know, we over-index in using mobile, being on the phone, surfing the internet, purchase online, you know, spending time online, spending time watching TV. We can harness that to really build our economic empowerment, and that's where we'll be successful.
Absolutely, with survivors. Give them your contact information real quick.
Not online. You know where to go. Buy Vibe Magazine or Uptown Magazine. My email address is in there. I'd be happy to give you my stuff.
Maze World 365, Len Burnett, CEO, co-founder.
Yeah, right.
Peace, y'all.
You know, really and finally, you know, to be receiving this reward about the idea of Inspired in New York. But the reality is when I came to New York, in this concrete jungle that we're in, you know, this is what really inspired us. Tonight, part of that award goes to New York itself, but more importantly, it goes to everyone here in this room that in some way, shape, or form have inspired me throughout my career.
And so, you know, to end, you know, not be too, I don't want to take Dougie's thunder, but, you know, what really inspires me again is, as Dougie says, hey, keep rising to the top and give it all you got, give it all you got.